Good morning, student. Today we will learn regarding measurement. What is measurement? You know, measurement is any device which allows the students to obtain information in a quantitative form. It is an act or process that involves the assignment of a numerical index to whatever is being assessed. The process of obtaining numerical description of the degree to which an individual possesses a particular characteristic. What are the essentials of measurement? See, identification and definition of the quality, attribute or variable that it is measured. Determining the set of operation through which the operation of attribute or variable may manifest and become perceivable. Establishment of a set of procedure for the translation of observations into quantitative statements of degree, extent or amount. Then see the functions of measurement. Number 1, prognosis. Number 2, diagnosis. Number 3, research and etc. Okay, then what are the criteria for selection of evaluated devices? See the criteria: sampling of objectives, sampling of content, validity, reliability, practicability, usefulness. What is validity? The validity of a test is the degree to which it measures what is intended to measure. Then see the types of validity. Number 1, phase validity. Number 2, construct validity. Number 3, content validity. Number 4, performance validity. Number 5, concurrent validity. Then see the reliability. Test, retest, reliability. It is a measure of reliability obtained by administering the same test twice over a period of time to a group of individuals. The scores from time 1 and time 2 can be correlated in order to evaluate the test for stability over time. Parallel forms reliability. In this type, it is a measure reliability obtained by administering different versions of an assessment tool. Both versions must obtain items that prove the same construct, skill, knowledge base and etc. to the same group of individuals. The scores from the two versions can then be correlated in order to evaluate the consistency of results across alternate versions. Then see the inter-rater reliability. It is a measure of reliability used to assess the degree to which different judges or raters agree in their assessment decisions. Then internal consistency reliability. It is a measure of reliability used to evaluate the degree to which different test items that probe the same construct produce similar results. In this, average inter-item correlation, split half reliability and all. Then the errors. What are the errors we can see in measurement? Number 1, random error. Number 2, systematic error. Then what is the difference between measurement and evaluation? Measurement refers to quantity describing in terms of pupils' attainment in a subject. For example, how much an individual performance has taken place means score in one subject. Then evaluation. Evaluation is measured in terms of quality and value judgment. For example, good, bad, normal. Then measurement, not a continuous process. Continuous process may be evaluation. It describes situation. In measurement, it describes 50 out of 100 marks in nursing education. In evaluation, evaluation judges its works and values it as average. Then measurement. It is only a tool to be used in evaluation, but does not include in evaluation. But in evaluation includes measurement and signifies a wider process of judging students' progress. In measurement, limited scope, but in evaluation, wide scope. What are the tests? Are standardized tests. Standardized tests are those tests stated the uniformity and equality in the scoring and administrating and interpreting the result. For example, any examination in which the same test is given in the same manner to all students. In standardized test, it is considered as an economical, reliable, valid assessment which continue or exist in institutions such as school, university, business and government. The tests are usually use multiple choice format. Then, according to psychometric test, covers only a narrow band of specialized intelligence. For example, TOEFL. TOEFL, you know, test of English as foreign language. Types of standardized test. Number 1, achievement test. Number 2, aptitude test. Number 3, intelligence test. Next, non-standardized test. Okay. Then aptitude test. According to Warren, aptitudes a set of characteristics symptomatic of an individual's ability to acquire with training some specific field of knowledge, skill or set of response. Then what is intelligence test? Intelligence is the global capacity of individual to think rationally, to act purposefully, to deal effectively with the environment. Then we see non-standardized test. A non-standardized test is one that allows for an assessment of an individual's abilities or performances, but does not allow for a fair comparison of one student to another. This type of test contrasts standardized tests such as State Educational Development Test and College Entrance Exam. You can see the classification in this clip, no? Non-standardized tests are written test, oral test, practical and performance test. In written, essay type and long essay, short answer, very short answer. Then in written test, objective type test. In this, selection, supply type. Validity of test. Validity is the ability of to test measure what it is intended to measure. Types of validity. You can learn more in slides, okay? Content validity, predictive validity, construct validity, concurrent validity. face validity and all. In reliability of test, the degree of accuracy, consistency with which an exam test measures what it seeks to measure a given variable. The degree of consistency among test scores. You can learn more in book. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask me frankly. Objectivity of test. The test is objective when the scorer's personal judgment does not affect the scoring. It eliminates fixed opinion judgments of person. Usability of test. The overall simplicity of use for a test, both constructor and learner. What are the characteristics of non-standardized test? In non-standardized test, we can see the following characteristics, such as constructed by test expert, covers broad or wide areas, objectives and content, selection of items will be done very carefully, and the validity reliability is checked. Uses of non-standardized test. See the uses. Number one, to know the ability and achievements of students, to help the teacher to assess strength and weakness of student, to provide continuous evaluation and feedback for the teacher. Then what are the limitations in non-standardized test? They are either too or short or too lengthy. Tests do not cover the entire content. Tests are usually hurried, conducted, supervision is not proper. Essay types examination or essay test. According to Robert Ely and David A.F., an essay test presents one or more questions or other tasks that require extended written responses from the persons being tested. Features. No single answer can be considered throughout and correct. The examinee is permitted freedom of response. The answer vary in their degree of quality or correlations. Then you can see the short open answer type test. You learn from this slide, okay? Then you see the percentile rank. A percentile is a measure that tells us what percent of the total frequency scored at or below the measure. A percentile rank is the percentage of scores that fall at or below a given score. Then you can see the more tests in given slides. Okay. Refer this.